Good morning. Governor Tom and First Lady Frances Wolf, Secretary Rivera, members of the Governor's Administration, my esteemed colleagues representing the fine colleges, universities, and schools of our great state, legislators, college trustees, and guests, welcome to Elizabethtown College. I'm Carl Strickwerda, president of the college. As our motto, Educate for Service, clearly articulates, Elizabethtown College educates our students for lives of service. Today, we're very pleased to be of service to the governor and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania in hosting today's important announcement. I thank Governor Wolf for bringing increased awareness to the problem of sexual assault on our college campuses, and for bringing college and university presidents and school administrators together for honest and open dialogue about a problem that has troubled higher education and the lives of young people for far too long. As President Obama said in 2014, when he launched the national It's On Us campaign, it is on all of us to reject the quiet tolerance of sexual assault and to refuse to accept what's unacceptable. I look forward to the conversation that will follow this announcement. Thank you, Governor Wolf, for bringing us all here together today to learn from each other and to develop best practices on how to respond to and to prevent sexual assault. Once again, welcome to Elizabethtown, and it's my great pleasure to introduce Kristen Avery with Generation Progress. Kristen.
Good morning, everyone. I'm so excited to be here today, and thank you so much to the Governor and First Lady for inviting me to be here to talk about this important issue. My name is Kristen Avery, and I'm the campaign manager for the It's On Us campaign. It's On Us is a cultural movement aimed at fundamentally shifting the way we think about sexual assault. In America today, 1 in 5 women and 1 in 16 men are sexually assaulted while in college. This number is simply unacceptable. In 2014, we at Generation Progress partnered with the White House to launch the campaign to address this issue. It's On Us is a rallying cry inviting everyone to step up and realize that the solution to end sexual assault begins with us, and that we must all come together as an entire community to create change on this issue. Since the start of the campaign, student leadership and college administrators across the country, including schools right here in Pennsylvania, have hosted 1,200 events on almost 500 campuses. We have successfully engaged campus communities and have partnered with over 90 organizations, including the NCAA, Snapchat, MTV, and Microsoft, in order to amplify this important message. Over 270,000 individuals have taken the It's On Us pledge, and I encourage you all to go to itsonus.org today to also take the pledge to be part of the solution. Over the past year and a half, we've seen a lot of change happening. This campaign and the students leading the charge have sparked thousands of conversations across the country. After the successes on campuses, the campaign launched It's On Us Communities last summer with the goal of engaging all community members, from elected officials to business leaders and parents, around bringing an end to the epidemic of sexual violence. This is a community-wide issue, and it's vital that the entire community is part of this conversation. We encourage you all to join the leaders here today in spreading the message that it is on us, all of us, to stop sexual assault. And with that, I'm happy to introduce the Governor and First Lady.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Kristen. That was really nice. I'm Tom Wolf. I'm Frances's husband, as I said. She's the First Lady of Pennsylvania, and I am really pleased to be here. Before I start, I want to thank Carl. Thank you very much for allowing us for hosting this event on Elizabethtown's campus. This is great to be here. And I want to just point out a few notables. Well, you're all notables, of course, but I mean people I really work with and for in the House of Representatives and the Senate. My bosses, and we're still working on that budget, but Kevin Schreiber, Representative Steve McCarter, and Madeline Dean, course, Pedro Rivera, the Secretary of Education, Senator Judy Schwenk, thank you for being here and for showing your sense of how important this really is. And I am really proud to announce the Pennsylvania, we're starting It's On Us PA. We are the first state to respond to President Obama's call for a real crusade, a real campaign against sexual assault. And Pennsylvania is the first state to do that, and I'm very proud to do this. So give yourself a round of applause. This initiative has three broad goals. First, we want to improve awareness, prevention, reporting, response systems in the Commonwealth. We want to do a better job. We want to make sure the processes are in place, that we all, in our colleges, in our schools, in our universities, we can do a better job of dealing and handling and responding to this issue. Second, we want to reduce or eliminate, if we can, the barriers that now incredibly keep victims, keep survivors from reporting instances of sexual abuse. We can't have that. And finally, we need to demonstrate, all of us, that we're committed to eradicating this scourge from Pennsylvania. So this campaign is really important. Let me just talk a little bit about the campaign. We need to treat sexual assault in our schools and colleges as the serious problem it truly is. We need to agree that we're not going to put up with it any longer here in Pennsylvania. That's because sexual assault has a corrosive effect on everyone, everyone. It clearly affects its survivors. It affects, though, the friends, colleagues, and family members of the survivor as well. It also affects all of us, and it happens a lot. Sexual violence is unfortunately pervasive in our society. It affects, as Kristen said, an estimated 1 in 5 college women. Nearly 20% of young women between the ages of 14 and 17 are sexually assaulted, mostly by someone the survivor knows and used to trust, a classmate, a supposed friend, a relative or a family member, and the impact is serious and widespread. Again, wherever it occurs, sexual assault affects the victim. The individual consequences are clear. Survivors are more likely to experience immediate and long-term health issues. Post-traumatic stress disorder, 94% of victims, of survivors. 75% experience depression. Between 35 to 50% are suicidal. And there are more. Survivors are more likely than their peers to abuse alcohol. They are more likely to drop out of school. They are more likely to have a lower GPA than their peers, all of which leads to an average reduction in lifetime income, an average, of over $240,000 over their lifetime. Now, just in Pennsylvania, you add up those percentages, that $240,000, that is $15.1 billion over the lifetimes of the survivors. Just in Pennsylvania. That's how much it costs us. So there are clear costs to the survivors of sexual assault, but there are also clear costs to those living and studying around them. When someone else is sexually assaulted, it reflects and often reinforces a number of very, very negative characteristics of the environment. It promotes a culture of unfairness. It promotes a culture of discrimination. It feeds on the pernicious idea that some people have clearer rights than others, that some, in George Orwell's terms, are more equal than others. It builds an environment of fear among the community of friends, acquaintances, and neighbors who know of the ordeal the survivor has gone through. And this inhibits and restricts freedom of action on the part of that entire community. The whole community suffers. Sexual assault places a barrier between people who have become concerned about the possibility of sexual assault and those with whom they might otherwise interact freely. It dampens the open exchange of everything from ideas to feelings. Finally, sexual assault reduces the quality of life for everyone, all of us, whoever we are, wherever we live. Safety is a fundamental civil right, and sexual assault is a clear violation of that fundamental civil right. When a violation like that occurs for any member of the community, it occurs for all of us. A society in which sexual assault is a big problem is a society in which the core values that we claim to hold dear, the Declaration of Independence, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, are little more than empty words. We need to end sexual assault for all of us. To this end, I have directed my administration to address this problem over the course of the next year and beyond. We have great partners in this effort. and over 40 colleges, universities, and school districts in Pennsylvania have already signed the pledge. Many of you are here. Brian, I didn't see you before. Good to see you. And the hope is that many more will join this group. We also have a network of 50 rape crisis centers across this state, ready and willing to work with our schools, colleges, and universities to make sure that we address this scourge effectively. And of course, at the heart of this is the Pennsylvania Commission for Women, which is doing a great job, not the least of which is to helping to sponsor this. It's truly on all of us to accomplish this task. And I am determined to make Pennsylvania a shining example for the rest of the world, so that what we do here becomes that example for others to follow. It's truly on all of us to accomplish this, so let's get to work. Thank you very much. Now, Randy, time for you. I think we're going to, not here, I don't mean up here, but we're going to turn this event over to, we're going to start the real conversation. I know you're all being nice, you were here to hear me talk, right? But the real issue here today is we're going to kick this off with a conversation about how we address this issue, how we address this crisis. And Randy is the, of course everybody knows that you are the chair of the commission, Pennsylvania Commission for Women. And we also have, again, Secretary of Education Pedro Rivera, and the two of them will co-chair this conversation. So let's move on to that session, I guess, in the next room, right? And thank you again, all of you, for being here. Really appreciate it. Thank you.